My name is Jan Alberto Emperador from BPA C2020 and this is my report. It's all about the street level bureaucracy.
Street level bureaucracy, SLB, is a sociological theory that seeks to explain the working practices and belief on frontline workers in public services and the way in which they enact public policy in their routine. Street level bureaucracy, frontline public service, thus will provide benefit and sanction to citizens. Street level bureaucrats deliver public policies. Why street level? Bakit nga ba sila? Distance from the legislative bodies that create policy. Distance from the bureaucracies that dictate them. So, sino-sino nga ba sila? Who are this SLB? Teacher, police officer, social worker, and the doctor.
Okay, we can go to the next topic. Ano nga ba ang nakapaloob dito sa the shaping of the policy? Enabling legislation assign authority to agency to fill in the detail of how policy is to be implemented. Implementation, process of the putting a policy plan, law, or regulation into practice. Autonomy, bureaucrat enter a political process with high level of autonomy. Proposed regulation, published in the Federal Register, Daily Journal of the Federal Government. Law of the control, the Bureaucracy Freedom of Information Act, 1966. National Environment Policy Act, 1969. Privacy Act, 1974. Government in the Sunshine Act, 1976. Congressional Oversight Power, Budgetary and Personnel Control. Congressional Committees, Judicial Review. Okay, next forward to Iron Triangle. Meron dito nakapaloob. Ito ay ang Congress, Bureaucracy, and Interest Group. Congress, Finding and Political Support, Policy Choices, and Execution. Bureaucracy, Law Regulation, Special Favor. Congressional Support, Via Lobby. Interest Group, Electoral Support, Friendly Legislation and Oversight. Okay, let's go to the next. Complex Working Condition. Ano nga ba ang nakapaloob dito? Problem of Resources. Demand for services is almost always higher than supply. Government tries to provide service to as many people as possible. Better services often increases demand, resulting increased capacity, not increase in quality. Ambiguity of goals, challenging relationship with client. Client participation is often not voluntary, unlike costly private market. Less affluent persons are more likely to engage multiple service provider. Street-level bureaucrats have a relative leverage over client. Inherent inequality plus overbend incentives to minimize time spent. Complex working condition. Under time and resources constraint, professionals tend to gauge a client worthiness of service based on general characteristic and first impression to expedite decision-making. So, ano naman ang meron dito sa rationing services? Bar amount of services given to client. So, ano nga ba ang meron dito sa rationing services? Meron siyang queuing, prioritizing, creaming, worker bias. Sa queuing, prioritizing professional time, first come, first serve. By appointment, waiting list. Prioritizing, paying more personal attention. Making exception to rules. Ignoring a client discretion, creaming, choosing only client that are more likely to be successful. Worker bias, likability, social demographic variables, societal norms. Okay, ang last naman natin is ang conserving resources, controlling the situation by. Dito naman sa bulletin na to, sa conserving resources ay ang husbanding, creating a reservoir of excess resources that can be used when needed. Screening, the processing of information about client before they interact with service professional. And last, the rubber stamping, when professional routinely accept the judgment of other professionals as their own.